Hello everyone, this is Suhasini from Living with Nature, and today we are going to talk about this amazing house plant called Adenium. Now, Adeniums are also called as desert rose, and like the name suggests, desert rose, like a rose or the flower that grows into a desert. So it tells us that the water requirements are very, very less. It thrives when given less water. So yes, let's get into the video. So first thing, let's talk about the watering requirements, that you don't have to water it very often or every single day or every alternate day. No, you water it once a week, or like I always say, when it comes to watering all the house plants, check for the soil. Now I'll show you something. Look at the soil, it's dry, absolutely dry. I'll go in even deeper. My finger is absolutely clean, some dust, that's it. It's 100% dry. So you have to keep it in mind that if you overwater it, this cordex, it's going to rot. It will have fungus, it's gonna rot away, and the plant will definitely dry up and die. And so yes, do not overwater. Always do this finger test, the soil test, and then only water it. You can do it once a week or once in 10 days, depending upon the place you are living. Now let's talk about what kind of soil we should use when planting Adenium. So you can see that again, the soil is very it looks kind of porous, and it should be well draining. I think that goes for all the plants, that whenever we are planting new plant, the soil should be well draining, because if water accumulates, be it any plant, it's going to have a root rot. So take 60% sand, 40% garden soil, and I think it would be sufficient. I'm not talking about vermicompost and everything, because that I'm going to cover when we'll talk about the fertilizing of this plant, what all fertilizers it requires. So yes, take more sand, or 50%, but I would suggest that take 60% sand to make it more porous. It has to be completely porous. Now, point number three, sunlight. Please keep it in mind that this is a very tropical, subtropical plant. It's native to Africa, guys. And it's found in the south of Sahara. So, it does very well in full sunlight. I'll repeat, full sunlight. If it doesn't get sunlight, that goes for any plant, if it doesn't get its requirement, it won't thrive, it won't stay healthy. So yes, you have to give it like 5 to 6 hours of proper sunlight. I'm not saying bright light, I'm not saying indirect sunlight, no, but full sun. You put it on your terrace, put it in your balcony, put it out there in the sun, and it's going to be very, very happy. Okay, so yes, next point number four, being the fertilizer. So now this plant requires fertilizing. If you'll not fertilize, it will not bloom, guys. You have to fertilize in the growing season. So you see that it's November, it's almost mid-November, and the plant is still blooming. And in Mumbai, we don't have a very harsh winter. Like even in winters, we have, pretty warm days. So here we don't have any difficulties. But if some of you all are living in colder regions, like north and all, or where it gets really cold, so during the winter, please do not water it. You water it like once in 15 days or so. Otherwise, the plant, because this plant goes into a dormant stage, and it doesn't grow, it stops growing. So during winters, generally people prune it and put it into, kind of adormancy so that the plant can store its energy and prepare for the next flowering and growing season. But I am not, doing any pruning or something, any major pruning. I've never pruned it. If you guys want me to, prune it a little bit and then we can grow one of the stems, so you can write down in the comment section below and we can do it together. So yes, I was talking about fertilizing. So yeah, you fertilize it in spring, maybe Feb or so, or after monsoon also. But what I generally do, I fertilize it maybe once in 2 months or so, and I give it potash, and I give bone meal and vermicompost. This is something that I give it to Adenium, and you can see that it is still blooming, it is still growing. This is not generally, if you're there in north and all, it stops growing by November and all, but you can see my plant, it's growing very nicely. Lot of new leaves, new growth is coming in. Let me turn it, and again let's focus it. Yeah, let's look at the flowers, and I'll tell you, all these stems, this one, that one, the other one, all of them had flowers. And suddenly it struck me that I had not shared a video or made a video on Adenium in the longest time. So yes, you have to fertilize it to get blooms, otherwise it's not gonna bloom. So give it vermicompost, give it bone meal, give it potash, give bone meal, potash, and vermicompost to all flowering plants, be it gardenia, be it rose, be it jasmine, because these boost the flower growth into the plant. So yes, I think I've covered up most of the things. Give it full sunlight, keep the soil well draining, do not overwater it, water it only when the soil is dry. This is something that you're going on a vacation, you give some water to it, go out for 10 days, the plant is going to be, all happy and healthy, not droopy at all when you come back. So yes, that's all for today. I hope you liked the video. If you liked it, please comment, please give some suggestions, please shower your love like you always do. And thank you so much for watching. Until next time, happy gardening!